What I've tried to tell the national media and what I hope that people realize is, yes, this was a no-name, not-funded little House member that had a message of returning government back to the people. Right. That was the key. This Join the Movement tour was always intended to make sure it was never about a person. It was about making sure that people take control of their government, that elected officials remember who it is that they work for, and that government understand the value of a dollar. That's what this win meant. Well, this is what I'll tell you. The immigration issue has been very interesting from the standpoint of Arizona has either been praised or attacked. But the bottom line is Arizona did what they had to because the federal government has failed to act. They have failed to secure the borders, and they are only going to see more and more states continue to take the stand that Arizona has because they've got to defend themselves. At some point, the federal government has to realize they don't have a lot to do in this country, but that is one thing that they do have to do, and they have just totally failed. I'm a co-sponsor coming in of the Arizona law. I think it's a good law. I think it does handle a lot of the issues. I think that the law that we passed a couple of years ago addressed that, but I think this is a changing country, and we really have to look at what the federal government's doing to make sure that we deal with that. What we don't want is amnesty. That's never an option. What we do want is accountability so that we can see exactly which businesses are hiring illegal immigrants, which penalties are being fined to those businesses, and what we're doing about it. And I think we need to make sure we've already passed a law that doesn't give state funding or scholarships to illegal immigrants. But we also need to look at how many are coming in and why, and make sure that the bill that we have in place is working. And if it's not, we need to make it stronger. The amazing thing is we have to understand we've got to protect this country. We've got to protect the businesses in this country. We've got to protect the people of this country. And we have to protect the taxpayers of this country. And illegal immigration goes against all of that. I am the daughter of legal immigrants. And what I can tell you is while we are a country of immigrants, we are a country of laws. When you give up being a country of laws, you have given up everything that our country is founded on. Which goes into the next part of the question is, you know, we always have to remember we are one country under God. And I think that we have watched the federal government go so far away from that. We are going to see our states turn around and take that back. We need to realize that faith and religion is a very big part of at least who the people of South Carolina are.
You bet.
It's a big part of the people of this country. It is the reason we are so patriotic, and it's something that needs to stay. And so the more that gets challenged, the more we need to fight back, because that is what brings the conscience to the people. That is what brings the conscience to elected officials, and I'll do everything I can to stop it. I'm an NRA, I've gotten an A by the NRA every year, but what really matters to me is I'm a CWP holder myself.
Yeah, me
and
too.
South Carolina is a right to carry state, but I personally don't think it is a right to carry state, because you can turn around and go across the street and you're suddenly breaking the law.
Right.
I think there are too many regulations in there that don't allow people to protect themselves. So if anything, I want to see it in a way that it's strengthened so that people can carry and feel comfortable carrying and protecting their homes and protecting their families. Well, and let's face it, this is a new day and time where we are seeing intrusion from Washington that we've never seen before.
You bet.
I think as we are losing more and more faith in our members of Congress, they are going to start looking to governors for good conservative policy. This is what I will tell you that I will do in the Haley administration, is as D.C. pushes things down, let's take health care, for example,
okay.
Is if I were in office when that happened, I'm going to get a coalition of governors. We are going to stand up there and say, we are the governors that represent these states. These are the people that we represent. Rather than mandating health care on every one of our individuals in our states, instead, let our states offer incentives to small businesses for offering health care. Let us pass tort reform like Texas, where mm-hmm. neurosurgeons and OBGYNs are flocking to their state.
Right.
Let us turn around and have accountability measures between the physician and the insurance companies. What the federal government needs to do is turn around and allow insurance companies to cross state lines so
sure.
it's competitive and efficient. When you turn around and tell D.C. no, and you tell them, no, this is what we're going to do. We don't need you to get involved. But instead, this is what we do need you to do. You're not just saying no, but you're giving a solution. That's what we need to start doing, is showing D.C. why they don't need to get involved, why states' rights matter, and why we should be able to control our own states. I will work very hard on that, because my concern when we're seeing bailouts and stimulus packages and health care mandates, all of this is not going to stop until we put a stop to it. I think it's up to the governors to now put a stop to it.